This is a pivotal moment in the whole build. What we're doing is we're about to tip this thing for the first time ever.
Back in the summer of 2018, I quit my job, packed my bags, and with some dedicated friends, we got to work building my dream energy independent 100% solar powered camper van. These are the lost tapes in our new series, showcasing all the details of the Root del Sol's van build. This is where the journey from Alaska to Argentina began.
There's Brett. Brett's pulling out the winch cables now, and it's gonna go and hook up onto that cable right there. So that's where we're at. I'm exhausted. I'm about to drive away. Brett, Kira, and the kids left this morning, so that was pretty sad, but also happy because we've reached the end of a certain part of this project. I'm gonna set this thing up over here behind me, and we're gonna watch this thing tip, hopefully for the first time. There's a few weak points on the structure here that we're worried about. I'll run over those really quickly before I put this camera down. These welds here, those welds are potentially dangerous. They may or may not start to crack with time or even on the first time that we start pulling down on this thing. I sized this wire here because I thought that might, well, you sort of sized it for the pound weight ratio for what we're lifting. And it seemed all right, but like anything, you should probably go overkill and try and get thicker wire. So I didn't get thick enough wire, potentially. We're gonna go real slow, take everything real slow and easy. We're not gonna push too hard on this thing. So let's see this thing tip for the first time.
Oh, you got a jerk over here.
Coming?
Yeah. You're going.
Ah, it works.
How's the tension look on those?
That's gonna break, that last one.
Yeah, how are the panels looking though? It looks like they're...
Good, man. Look at it. It works.
Yeah. We got a lift.
I just need that to break, so then I can go for it. That last one. So we need thicker cable, some different joiners, because Brett, you were right, they were pretty weak. So I'm saying this publicly, you were right, they were weak. And that's it, we're heading to the hardware store. We got 20 minutes before it closes. So hopefully we get there in time, we can get this thing lifted. We're about to try it again. We fixed everything that we think that we can fix, and here we go.
So the thing about the build of this van is that everything happened not entirely the way that it was supposed to happen. This part of the video was shot in an alleyway next to Brett Reinhardt's house in Seattle, Washington, which we had driven to from Ashland, Oregon with the entire BELAN family. They came to support me in the final stages of the build, but also had their own personal family matters to deal with. Hence the emergency flight they had to run and catch. We were all super exhausted, and for good reason. However, there was still a lot of question marks for the next solo leg of the journey. For example, we had barely tested the solar panel's capacity to charge the van at the point that I was taking this video. Literally the next day, I was getting on a ferry at Bellingham, Washington to take a 3-day boat ride to Haines, Alaska. After I got off the ferry, I began my journey in self-sufficiency. In the most rawest of ways. This time lapse was the very first time this van was charged off of the sun. One or two locals stopped by out of curiosity, questioning what it was that I was doing, but also to tell me to be aware of all the grizzly bears around while I had my back turned while working on the van. The next day, I would begin my 600-mile, 6-day journey to pick Keegan, my media man, up from Fairbanks to start the documentation of the journey.
Dirty Australian. You have to pull out evenly on both sides, otherwise they get caught. And it's a pain in the arse.
Here, somewhere up in the Arctic Circle, you can see me teaching Keegan for the very first time how the array works. I can remember still being very frustrated with it, as I hadn't yet figured out all of its quirks. I think Keegan was just stoked he was going for a super long UFO ride.
It does not look like a spaceship. It's looking less like a spaceship, more like a UFO.
What's this thing's a UFO out in the Arctic, so people drive past and they're like, what the fuck is that?
Because I've only done it once before, and it wasn't very promising.
Did it work?
It worked, but it was like, it was sketchy.
After we'd made our voyage to the Arctic Circle, we found ourselves back in Fairbanks, Alaska again. Where on the first full sunny day, we decided to try our luck at tracking the solar array for the first time on the trip. Things were very sketchy.
There's so much pressure on that arm like that. Pulling in nearly like 4.5 kilowatts now.
Compared to what?
Compared to
2.5.
We're trying to take down the solar panels after we have been tracking all day. The whole thing has just snapped off. Doing Josie.
All right, mate.
All right.
Could be better, but I guess that's what happens when you're playing with toys like this. You got to roll with the punches. Sometimes the punches are big blows.
Yeah.
So we're pretty much down to 2/3 of our solar ability. Now I'd say, without using the other ones as satellites until we can get someone to help us fix these arms.
With a broken solar array, we limped back to Whitehorse in the Yukon Territory, where we could at least get the array back to a fully deployable standard.
We're actually fixing the van so we can get back on the road again. Zach's in there welding for us, and we should have all of our issues a bit more ironed out by the end of the day. We've just repaired our arms. Zach here has welded our hinges back together. They're super strong now, and what we're going to see is we're going to see these arms tilting and not twisting so much anymore. I mean, I don't see why you'd want to go any further than that.
No.
We literally drove from Fairbanks to Ashland with a non-functional solar array. Despite the difficulty of that, as we passed back through Ashland, we decided it was now time to finish the job we'd started at the very beginning of the journey.
So our actuator is going to mount from about here on the box up to that top corner there on the array, and then it's going to lift the array up because right now we don't have the ability to track. I'm also going to mount another actuator around here somewhere, and then a third actuator back down to here, and that's why I have this fender off. That's what I'm currently working on.
For the past few days, Jolie and Brett have been engineering the tracking system on our solar array so that we can use these actuators to lift them up. Yeah.
There's no weight on that thing.
Hopefully it'll work. So welded all that together, welded an attachment here behind the fridge in the van.
Alright, let's try it.
10 seconds, what are you doing, Joel?
10 seconds. I'm waiting for Brett to get a beer, and I'm probably going to go over 10 seconds, so I'm sorry. I'm really excited because since we built this van, we've been trying to track these solar panels. By tracking, you get up to 40% more efficiency out of your panel. Very excited about that. It's going to open up a whole new living space for us on the roof. We've just spent the better part of a week mounting these new actuators that we've bought. We just did a little test. Brett did a little test just before, and everything seemed like it was working pretty good. So I am ready to set it up a little bit further this time and see what happens when we get it up real high, and this is kind of the riskiest part. Nothing really else to say other than I'm about to switch this thing on and see if it's magic or not. Up she goes.
Holy shit.
Oh man.
Fuck. Holy shit! Look at that beast!
That's like 30 degrees. You're gonna go 45.
Man, it goes up so much higher than that.
You're gonna go 45 for sure.
How's it looking?
It looks solid.
It looks beautiful. So it looks so pretty.
Oh, this is a great shot right here.
Dude.
Nah, I like the winches better. BELAN from SOLARROLLA, hailing from the Smith River, California, where we are at one of our favorite places to camp mostly because we have a wonderful solar window here. Joel Gregory Hayes, along with Keegan Tacori, are coming down from the Arctic Circle on their fully solar-powered journey in this van. Check out these panels. This is 7,940, I think, nominal watts of solar. Well, I don't believe there's anything on the road like this, so we really want to share with people what's possible. So the one thing is, when Joel came through Ashland and we built this vehicle last year, we used kind of a winch type of tracking system to really tip the array towards the sun to get that maximum amount of power. It really just was kind of cumbersome and really made it difficult for Joel to track and really get that power. So while Joel was in Ashland, we built a tracking system using actuators. So let's take a look at those real quick. Here you can see the actuators. So these are 60-inch, you can call them jacks if you like, because that's what they do. They jack things up. So what we had to do was position these actuators in a way that jacks up this huge array. And that gives us the ability to get almost 45 degrees and therefore really capture that morning sun and then also follow that sun down in the evening.
Finally, with a fully functioning solar array, for the first time in the trip, we were on our way south and fast. With a tracking function, this van can charge as much as 50 kilowatt hours a day or between 80 and 100 miles. This positivity streak obviously had to come crashing down at some point though, right?
Holy shit. No. They said it just came off straight away and I looked in the rear view and I saw it smash.
There in Baja, Mexico, with the resources we had at our disposal, we tried our best to repair the damages to the solar array, but things weren't looking too good.
Happy days!
We were able to put the array back together, so it was mechanically functional, but it was our damaged solar panels that we feared the most.
What's the damage look like on the panels? That's the most important thing.
Oh yeah.
After we repaired the array for what seemed like the millionth time, a final catastrophic flaming set of solar panels put it all to rest. We were all out of luck and returned back north where we will build what we hope is our last and final version of the solar array.